And if you ask me if I will buy one again, yes, I will do. That's the first choice. We are in Sjövik, and that's located 40 kilometers northeast of Gothenburg. It's all about metals. So we have the 10, 15, 12% of non-ferrous. Non-ferrous, it's not the Fe, it's aluminum, it's the stainless, you have copper, lead, every metal not magnetic. I think we are one of the three biggest non-ferrous plants in Europe.
We try to go deeper in the sorting to be able to take out as much as possible in as few steps as possible. So we have some piles that they are 50% okay, but we want to have them 100% okay. The aim is to get the cleanest metal possible from a dry separation step. You can run up to 6 tons in the standalone, but mainly we go for 3 tons since we have handpicking afterwards. They take out errors from the sorting. If we go for brass, copper or stainless, we need to have handpickers to clean out the material so we can have a real sellable fraction after the first run.
Every machine has a PLC or a system, but we have an overriding system put these different machines together. And that's also special built for this plant. It starts with Spalek, and then we sort it up in different size. It's 0 to 5, 5 to 20, 20 to 60, 60 to 120 millimeters.
This is the first time for me I'm using a Spalek active feed, and it works well. We have less start and stops due to the active feed. We have a more fluent process of the material, and we have then easier to calculate the throughput of the machine and how much do they handpick for the moment and how is the quality. If we want to have 15 tons an hour, I just set it on 15 tons and it delivers 15 tons an hour. Easy to handle and easy to work with for all involved, the staff and the managers. The screen is working well and we have had no issues so far with the machine and we are satisfied.
We don't have to rebuild some older lines, so it was not mixed with old and new machines. Everything was new and designed to work together. But of course we worked with the business case. We have the numbers, we gave you some numbers what capacity we want to. And of course we start building the business case after your big sieve. I think we have a good cooperation. There have never been any questions. I always can reach you during the hot time in the project. We have several teams meeting and you always answer the question. So I'm very happy and safe with Spalek. That's the best.
Yeah, it's working fluently, I say. We have not had any issues with that one. So it's doing its job and we think we have reached the capacity of what we can process with our material. And we have also made some reruns with the material and made trials, but it's working fluently as it's supposed to do. Yes, the capacity is no problem at all.
I think even that we can pull through more material than we expected.
And that's one of the possibilities with the sieve, that you can change the mats and the decks to fit more the downstream afterwards.
But that's not the bottleneck today. No, no, no.
We try to toggle it to see how many persons we need for handpicking. For example, if you have 2 persons handpicking, maybe we put 1, 1.5 ton an hour. If I have 4, I can go up to 3, maybe 4 tons. And that's how I use the settings for the throughput on the active feed. But on the main line, it's working perfect.
The goal is to not put so many hands on it. Let the machine work. But then I think we need more machines. But the capacity for the sieve from Spalek is good enough. We can put in more machines. That's not the bottleneck. We could run it 3 shift, 24 hours, but it's only one missing part here. It's the material.